Beijing has reacted furiously to Defence Minister Peter Dutton's comparison of China's rise to Nazi Germany. China's foreign ministry accused the government of advocating for war. It says it has no intention of creating a military base on the Solomon Islands, a claim Australia's top spy has dismissed.
Slammed as fake news,
这种卑劣做法,
Beijing quick to nip national security fears in the bud, accusing Canberra
中国人民看的,
of using the Solomon Islands for its own political gain. As fears mount, China is planning to build a military base in the Solomon Islands, less than 2,000 kilometres from Australia's east coast. Even though the Prime Minister of the strategic island nation has given his word, it's not on the cards.
That's the position of the government.
He vowed publicly as well as privately that there would be no Chinese military base, no long-term presence, no power projection.
But Australia's top spy says China wants to be the world's leading power.
On the way to achieving that global objective, it needs to establish dominance in Asia, in the Indo-Pacific.
In a rare public appearance, Andrew Shearer warns,
China wants a region where it has sustained military presence, where it can complicate US military operations and Australia's military operations and make those more difficult in a crisis.
The deal opens the door for China to put boots on the ground in the Solomons in the form of troops or police.
I think it's likely that that will be the path that China will be taking in the Pacific region.
That's not the only concern the Home Affairs Minister holds. Karen Andrews is now suggesting the announcement of this deal is Beijing's attempt to ruin the chances of the coalition winning another term in government.
Why now? Why right in the middle of a federal election campaign is all this coming to light? I mean, we talk about political interference and that has many forms.
But if the polls are anything to go by, it could be ruining its own chances. Stella Todorovic for 10 News First.